It is a new year. We are officially in 2014. Where does time go? I don't understand. But as usual, at the start of the year, I like to tell you guys what movies I'm most looking forward to that are coming out this year. At the end of this video, I'm going to be telling you guys about some of the movies that are coming out this year that I'm not looking forward to. Stay tuned for that, but let's get started. Now this January, there's gonna be some films that are expanding that came out late December last year in very select theaters, like a handful of theaters. A lot of people asked me where my reviews for Lone Survivor and Her were. Can't do anything about it. It hasn't opened in Ohio yet, but it will be opening here soon, and I'm looking forward to seeing those movies. And that's really all I care about in January. The movies that were going to come out last year are expanding in January to other territories. Besides that, January can go screw itself. On February 7th, we have The Lego Movie. Now, this movie could be awful. It really could be terrible, but something about it looks really smart and clever, and I think the way that they use the childish humor could actually bring a strength to this movie and make it really fun. Also on February 7th, we have The Monuments Men, directed by George Clooney, with a humongous cast filled with very talented people. This movie was originally supposed to come out in 2013, but according to George Clooney, some of the special effects weren't finished yet and he wasn't comfortable releasing it yet. That's the story that's going around the city. The city being the internet. On February 12th, we have RoboCop. This movie could go either way, just like the Lego movie. It could be awful, it could be good. But even if it is good, it has to be good in the type of way that Dredd was good, where it remade certain elements of the original and made it way better. But that's tough to do because the original Judge Dredd with Sylvester Stallone wasn't really that good, so the remake had it easy. The original RoboCop is a very beloved film by many fans. And so this movie has a ways to go, but we'll see how it is. On February 12th, we have the next film in the continuing Liam Neeson dominates the months of January and February non-stop. If you haven't noticed, Liam Neeson movies tend to come out in January and February. Taken, The Grey, Unknown, all January and February movies. Apparently those are his months. This movie could also be awful. I mean, if you saw Taken 2, you'll understand why I'm saying that. But I know that Liam Neeson will at least be fun to watch, and it's cool to see him kick ass. This movie could be fun, but it could really be stupid though, and there is the possibility that it's gonna go that way, but we will see when the movie comes out. On March 7th, we have Grand Budapest Hotel, the next film by Wes Anderson. I haven't really watched much about this movie. I've stayed away from trailers and images and whatnot because as a filmmaker, Wes Anderson really impresses me most of the time, and so I don't really wanna know much about it. I'm looking forward to it simply because of the talent involved with it. On March 21st, we have Muppets Most Wanted. I really like the new Muppets movie. I thought it was a lot of fun. This one has a different cast, though, and different people involved with it, different directors and whatnot. Of course, why do you go to see a Muppet movie? The Muppets. And they're in it. So it has the possibility of being awesome. On March 28th, we have Noah, the new Darren Aronofsky film retelling the biblical tale of the man in the ark and all the animals and his family. Hopefully it's going to be interesting and visually impressive. As a filmmaker, Darren Aronofsky amazes me with almost every movie he puts out. Also on March 28th, we have The Raid 2. And now if you guys saw The Raid, that was a pretty incredible action film. But it sort of centered around this gimmick that there was just this one apartment building and it was just levels and levels of chaos. This one looks like it really expands that idea and goes deeper than that. On April 4th, we have Captain America, The Winter Soldier. Obviously, I'm excited for this movie because I'm a nerd and I like people who wear shiny tights and do things with superpowers and whatnot, and it's... I like that. The first Captain America film was a movie that I had fun with. It was sort of like the first Thor. I enjoyed it. It had elements of it that I thought were entertaining to watch, but there were definitely things about it that could have been improved significantly. I'm hoping that Captain America the Winter Soldier does that, because from what I'm hearing, it's more of like a spy movie, espionage, more realistic, and I really like that take on it, and I hope that it succeeds. On April 18th, we have Wally Feister's new film, Transcendence. Now, Wally Feister is the director of photography for Christopher Nolan. This is his first film that he is directing. It stars Johnny Depp and a lot of other talented people. It's looking kind of like we have our Nolan Jr. here. It's sort of an interesting idea, and I really like the way that the trailer looks, but it didn't really hook me instantly. On May 2nd, despite my thoughts on the trailer and my thoughts on the first film and the way it looks like it's going, The Amazing Spider-Man 2 still has my curiosity. It doesn't quite have my attention yet, though, unfortunately. That was a Django Unchained reference. And I'm hoping that the filmmaker Mark Webb can pull off a really good movie here. 500 Days of Summer was great. I think that he's learned from certain things that went on with the first one. He'll be more experienced this time around, and I'm hoping that it is better than the first. On May 16th, we have Godzilla. This trailer was awesome. And Bryan Cranston is in it, and I think that guy at this point knows how to pick a good script. I just want to see a global destruction Godzilla, where it doesn't seem like it's this great, fun, hilarious adventure, where it actually seems like what would happen if a giant dinosaur just appeared and destroyed the Earth. It would be horrible. So I really want this film to have that feel to it. On May 23rd, we have Bryan Singer's return to the X-Men universe, X-Men Days of Future Past. That, what I just said alone, makes me excited for it because, while I haven't been too impressed with much of his films since the X-Men films, he did direct two great X-Men movies, and I'm hoping that he's able to do that with this one. And I'm really hoping this film is able to meld those two franchises, that of X-Men First Class and the original X-Men films, and make it awesome. On June 6th, we have a movie that looks like a pretty cool video game, starring Tom Cruise, directed by Doug Liman, the guy who brought us The Bourne Identity. Now, those things right there, I mean, I like video games, I like Tom Cruise, and I like The Bourne Identity. And I like Emily Blunt too, and she is looking good in this trailer, and I'm hoping that this movie is awesome. Now, a lot of people have said it looks like a video game, and they've said that as a way to diss the movie. And I'm like, I like video games. I don't really feel like that's a proper insult. Most people actually like video games. Now, yes, not all video games are supposed to be like movies, and vice versa, but this movie looks like it supports that type of fun action, and I'm hoping that it's awesome. I love sci-fi, and I love mechs too, when used in a cool way, and this movie has, you know, he's running in his suit, and Tom Cruise is running, and you get to see Tom Cruise run, which is awesome because Tom Cruise runs really cool, but he's also in a robot suit now and he's running. So I'm totally, obviously, a nerd for a robot suit guy running from explosions. On July 11th, we have Dawn of the Planet of the Apes, directed by Matt Reeves. And one of the reasons I'm very excited for this movie was because I enjoyed the first one, Rise of the Planet of the Apes, and I think that Matt Reeves is a very talented director, and I really think he can take this in really interesting directions. Also, it has Gary Oldman, and anytime Andy Serkis does motion capture work for anything, I mean, there's only one guy in Hollywood who's gotten Oscar buzz for motion capture work, and that's Andy Serkis. And I'm very excited to see what this film brings. On July 25th, we have Jupiter Ascending, the Wachowskis' new movie starring Channing Tatum and Mila Kunis. I wasn't really that impressed by the trailer. I'm not really hooked yet. But the directors have my curiosity, and that's why I'm interested in this film, because these guys made The Matrix, one of my all-time favorite movies. On August 1st, we have a movie that I'm strangely curious about, which is kind of sad, because it's a Marvel movie, and I should be more excited for it, but Guardians of the Galaxy really is something that I'm hoping could be totally different and original, which from what I've heard of all the source material and the directions they're taking the movie, it will be those things. I'm just hoping that it works, because the end credits scene in Thor 2 was really frickin' weird. On August 15th, we have the third installment in a movie series that is continuing to make grown men cry each year, and that is The Expendables 3. The first one just felt like it was trying to be something that it wasn't. The second one really understood that it's just a cheesy action movie filled with all these people from your youth, and you're supposed to enjoy watching them shoot and punch things. And it did it fairly well, I thought. I'm hoping the third one continues in that same vein. On November 7th, we have what is most likely my most anticipated film of the year, and that is Interstellar, a movie we don't know that much about, but it's directed by Christopher Nolan, stars Matthew McConaughey, and a whole bunch of people who are talented. It involves wormholes and time travel and science fiction things, and I am excited purely for that. I didn't talk much about the trailer because it'd kind of be like me just struggling to figure out something to talk about for 3 minutes because there really wasn't that much in the trailer, but that's the point. It's a teaser. When a teaser actually comes around that teases people like it's supposed to without spoiling everything, people get all up in arms about it, but then they all get upset when a trailer ruins things for them too. Internet, make up your mind. On November 14th, we have a film that I am interested in purely because I love the original. It's a film that I grew up with a lot as a kid. The directors of that film haven't really done hardly anything in the past few years that have inspired me. In fact, they were involved with Movie 43, which makes me like, I don't even know what this movie's going to be like. That being said, Dumb and Dumber 2 does star Jim Carrey and Jeff Daniels, and that right there is something to be excited about. On November 21st, we have The Hunger Games: Mockingjay Part 1. I really like Catching Fire quite a bit, and so I'm very excited for this movie, even though they're doing the cliched, we gotta cut this last book into two parts thing that everything seems to be doing nowadays. On December 12th, another film that I don't know that much about, it is called Tomorrowland. It's gonna be starring George Clooney and directed by Brad Bird. His last film was Mission Impossible 4. I've liked all of his cartoon films as well. So for that reason, I'm interested in this film, despite the fact that I don't know that much about it. That's something I also like, is that I don't know that much about it. I like not knowing that much about this film. And on December 17th, we have the final installment of The Hobbit, There and Back Again. I really enjoyed Desolation of Smaug. It really surprised me because I wasn't a humongous fan of the first one, even though I enjoyed it. It could have been improved a lot. The second one really improved it, and I really had a lot of fun with that second one, and I'm hoping the third one's even better. Now guys, as I told you, there are some movies coming out this year that I'm not really that excited about, but some people may think I should be. I'm simply not. Some of those films are Transformers 4: The Age of Extinction. Why are these movies still being made? It's still directed by Michael Bay. It's a different cast. that could maybe be good, but you know what? It's not. It's not going to be different. It's a Michael Bay movie. Everyone thought Pain and Gain was going to be different. It's still a Michael Bay movie with overprocessed, saturated colors, boobs and butts, and big muscular men and big wide curved shots where they zoom in on things. It's all the same. Also, the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles or Teenage Alien Ninja Turtles or whatever in the world's going to be, I don't care about that movie. What is it? Megan Fox is April O'Neil? What's going on with that? Now, here's a movie that some people are excited for that I'm simply not, and I'll tell you why. Sin City, A Dame to Kill For. I really enjoyed the first Sin City film, but they pushed this movie back almost a year? What kind of preparation is that, Robert Rodriguez? A year? It was supposed to come out like last year. A year? You pushed the movie back a year? And Paranormal Activity 5. Yes, we have Paranormal Activity, The Marked Ones. That's the first movie coming out in January. I will have a review for that. We also have another Paranormal Activity movie coming out. Why is this? What's going on? It's just a giant money-making franchise. That's what it is. They make these movies for $2. Like, if the opening weekend of this movie made, like, $5 million, it'd probably be a profit. And that's why these movies keep getting made, because they make them for nothing, and people go to see them. So, guys, I'm sure I missed some things. I looked at a list and tried to get as many of the releases down. There may have been some tentative release dates that weren't on the list that I saw. There may be some films I forgot. What are you guys looking forward to this year? As always, guys, thanks so much for watching. And if you like this, you can click right here and get Stuckmanized.